Hello friends, merhaba arkadaşlar. In this lesson we are going to learn the parts of the house. House is ev in Turkish. Ev. While we are learning the new vocabulary, please repeat after me loudly as much as possible. Let's start with this one. Door is kapı in Turkish. Two short syllables and stress is on the second. Kapı. One more time. Kapı. And this one is window in Turkish, pencere. Three short syllables. Pencere. One more time. Pencere. And this one is roof in Turkish, çatı. One more time. Çatı. And this one is the chimney in Turkish, baca. One more time. Baca. And this part of the house is the garden in Turkish, bahçe. Such a nice word. Bahçe. One more time. Bahçe. And this part, the wall, garden wall. And wall is duvar in Turkish. One more time. Duvar. All right, so door is kapı, window is pencere, roof is çatı, chimney is baca, garden is bahçe, and wall is duvar. Now let's see the rooms. The first room is the kitchen. In Turkish, mutfak. One more time, mutfak. And this one is the oven in Turkish, fırın. One more time, fırın. And this part is the cooker in Turkish, ocak. One more time, ocak. And this part is the cupboard in Turkish, it is dolap. One more time, dolap. And this one is the refrigerator or the fridge. In Turkish, it is buz dolabı. As you see, there is a compound noun here. Buz is ice and dolap is, as you see, cupboard. And together as a compound noun, we need to read it as buz dolabı. One more time. Buz dolabı. All right. And this one is the dishwasher. In Turkish, another compound noun, bulaşık makinesi. Bulaşık is dish and makine is machine. As a compound noun, we are going to read it as bulaşık makinesi. One last time, bulaşık makinesi. And lastly, this part is the sink and in Turkish it is lavabo. One more time, lavabo. All right. The next room is the living room. In Turkish, it is oturma odası. Room is oda and otur means sit. So instead of living room, actually in Turkish, we say sitting room. Oturma odası. All right. And this one is the armchair. In Turkish, it is koltuk. Arm is kol, an armchair is koltuk. And this one is the sofa, in Turkish it is kanepe. One more time, kanepe. All right. And this one, the curtains, is perde in Turkish. One more time, perde. And this one on the ground is the rug, in Turkish it is halı. One more time. Halı. And lastly, this one is the coffee table. In Turkish, it is sehpa. One more time. Sehpa. All right. The next room is the bedroom. Yatak odası. Bed is yatak and room is oda. Bedroom, yatak odası. And this one is, of course, yatak. Bed means yatak in Turkish. And this one is the pillow. In Turkish, it is yastık. One more time. Yastık. And this one, lamp, is so similar. Lamba. One more time. Lamba. All right. And this one is the wardrobe. A bit similar. In Turkish, it is gardrop. One more time. Gardrop. All right. And this one is the bedside table. In Turkish, it is komodin. One more time. Komodin. And this one is the drawer. In Turkish, it is çekmece. Drawer or pull is çek and drawer is çekmece. All right. And the next room is the bathroom. In Turkish, it is banyo. In some other languages, it's exactly the same, banyo. And here, this is bathtub. In Turkish, it is küvet. Two short syllables. Be careful, it is not küvet. It's ü with dots, so we need to read it as küvet. One more time. Küvet. And this one is the toilet. In Turkish, it is similar. Tuvalet. One more time. Tuvalet. And this one, we have learned it. Sink is lavabo. One more time. Lavabo. And this one here, the mirror is ayna. One more time. Ayna. And this one here, the towel is havlu. One more time. Havlu. All right. So these are the rooms of the house. Let's see how much we remember the things in these rooms. On the left, you can see the curtains, wardrobe, lamp, and cupboard. And on the right, the Turkish words for these objects. So let's start with curtains. Which word on the right means curtains? Remember? Exactly. Perde. Curtains, perde. How about wardrobe? It's a bit similar, remember? Wardrobe, gardrobe. Exactly. Gardrobe. Wardrobe, gardrobe. And the lamp is so similar. Exactly. Lamba. Lamp, lamba. And the last one is cupboard, dolap. Cupboard, dolap. All right, so curtains is perde, wardrobe is gardrobe, lamp is lamba, and cupboard is dolap. Let's see another exercise. A coffee table, an armchair, a sofa, and a mirror. And on the right, we see kanepe, sehpa, ayna, koltuk. So, which one is coffee table? Do you remember? Coffee table. Sehpa. Coffee table is sehpa in Turkish. How about armchair? Remember, arm means kol. And armchair means koltuk. Armchair, koltuk. And sofa? Sofa is exactly kanepe. Sofa, kanepe. And lastly, mirror is ayna. Mirror, ayna. So coffee table is sehpa. Armchair is koltuk. Sofa is kanepe. And mirror is ayna. All right, friends, if you have any questions about this lesson, please write them in the comment section. Do not forget to subscribe. Hope to see you in our following lesson. For now, goodbye. Hoşça kalın.